Strig, the Warlock King. It's going to be a lengthy Death Stranding segment today. I'm trying to finish the game before the second one comes out. Christ. But something else I was going to say. I don't know. Terrible at this. Yeah, sorry for the delay and lack of content. I've mostly been doing God of War shorts and things like that. I've mostly been doing God of War shorts and things like that. Because they're just quick and easy to record. I had video footage of my battle with Tyr on the third attempt, and I was trying to rush through it. I didn't upload the video, mostly because I didn't record it. I'd been playing another game called Stellaris for a bit, and when I went back to God of War, Stellaris is my guilty pleasure, by the way. I went back to God of War and I forgot all the controls, and I had suspended the game right before ascending to Tyr. And I got up there and he beat me to death with those damn scimitars. I'm pretty sure that's what they're called, scimitars. No. The scimitar is the long. Starts off narrow at the hilt, and as it. Like, it gets. In my opinion, absurdly wide for the top, and it has the little. To illustrate what I'm talking about, they're the swords from Aladdin that all the guards are running around with. That's a scimitar. The weapon Tyr's using in the third battle is the Egyptian equivalent of a scimitar, or the Persian equivalent. I can't remember what it is. I watched him build the things on Forged in Fire about probably a couple months ago. It must not have sunk in because I can't remember it. Anyways, that's what he has on the third one, and he beat me to death. Literally. Like, three times. I had three resurrection stones. It took me three of them to do it. Because one, I was having an anxiety attack. Two, he was moving real fast. And then, once I got him past half health, he turned off the lights on me. And then I was like, whoa, 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 whoa. And then he started attacking me from behind. Kind of thing. And that just... I got all discombobulated. Usually happens when there's too many things going on at once. Especially in video games. But yeah, so that happened. I'm now on round 4 with Tyr, and he's using a katana. But he also breaks out the other weapons occasionally, and it drives me batty. He hasn't tried to blind me or anything, but then he summons, like, his little minions mid-battle, and one of them's a freaking centaur. One of them's a freaking centaur with a spear, and it's got, I swear to God, it's got more health than he does. Insane. But yeah, so I've been doing those. That's where I'm at with the Valhalla thing. So I'll have that upload at some point when I finally beat him. It ain't happening today. Maybe later. As for Stellaris, it's like a galactic conquest game, and I took over the galactic community. They voted in the council, and then this machine machine alliance, like these sentient machine people, kept going to war against me, and they had more diplomatic power than I did. Well, I accumulated favors, like political favors from them, and then they tried to denounce me, and I was the second. So it was me and them on this council after they got it reduced down to two, thinking they were cool and that they were going to get me kicked off the council. It didn't work that way because everybody else is my subject. Like, I subjugated everybody else. So, like, they tried to denounce me, and I vetoed it. And then I proposed, like, I learned that I could propose certain resolutions to the Galactic Council. Like, I didn't know I could do that, and I figured it out. So I counter proposed that they be denounced, and I used all the favors I accrued from them, so they basically denounced themselves. Then once they did that, I proposed that the council be reduced to one, because what denouncing a society does, it lowers their diplomatic weight and all that crap, so they have less pull on the government. So I took over immediately, because they kept attacking me militaristically, and I had the same fleet power as them, so we kept coming to a draw each time. It got nowhere, so I was like, I'm just gonna take over the Galactic Council. I'm gonna use politics against you. So anyways, I denounced them. I got them kicked off the council. Council dropped down to one, and then I voted that I be nominated as the Galactic Custodian, which basically means you're like the president of the Galactic community. And then I proposed that I had, like, my term never end, that I be the constant custodian over the Galactic community. And because I had accrued all these favors from all these people, I kept using them to get what I wanted politically. And needless to say, it's now gone from the Galactic community to the Galactic Imperium. I took over the draft that window where the heat kicked on. I turned the Galactic community, the Senate per se, into I'm the Emperor now, is what I'm trying to say. I'm the Galactic Emperor, and then I abolished the Council, and I put into law something that's called Pax Galactica, and it's just the game's fancy way of saying, like, you can't declare war on other people, but they can't declare war on you as well. So I forced the Galactic community into peace, and I banned slave trade of all kinds, like organic and non-organic. Like, the community is, yeah, beautiful. But yeah, that's Solaris. That's my guilty pleasure. That game, I really love that game. And I don't remember where I found it, honestly. I really can't.
Beginning scan. Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID.
I don't know how any of the roads I built are doing, so I haven't played this game in I don't know, maybe 3 months? Two? Maybe 2 months now. I'll say two. I'd have to look at my videos. I really don't know. Yeah, like, I really have no clue. Right now I'm at a facility. I have to take on a quest that's going to take me, like, I have an hour, basically, in this game to get down, back down the mountain, drive back to the doctor, get a machine, and then drive all the way back because this man's wife is pregnant. And I'm pretty sure she's going to die. And if so, that means I'm going to have to drive her to a furnace. Easy enough, like, I know where it is, like, I have a road built by it, if people have upkept the roads. I built all kinds of them, and other people helped me do it, and, for the longest time, I was the only one putting materials back into the road. Let's see. Building that yet. It's not bad. Somebody must have been putting materials back into some of these. Guys are low though. I'll have to go back that way and never that. Some of that built. Oh, and somebody built that. How kind of them. Why didn't you folks connect that? They don't. Machine and driving back. Okay.
Clear. Weapons detected.
There you are. The Mountaineer just contacted me. The treatment I prescribed isn't working. We need to act fast. I hoped the antibiotics would alleviate the worst of the symptoms, but looks like we're past that stage. An infection like this so late in the pregnancy can cause any number of complications. Even if she survives, there is a risk she could suffer brain damage. Even brain death. Now, I need you to deliver this prototype bioprinter and remote medical terminal to the Mountaineer.
Damn.
If you can connect them to me via the chiral network, I can use this equipment to diagnose the patient's condition and provide treatment. The terminal will allow them to transmit their genetic code, with which I can formulate a DNA vaccine for printing. At present, only vaccines utilizing viruses and other non-living components can be generated in this fashion, but future advancements may free us of this limitation. It should go without saying, but this is delicate equipment. Don't break it, whatever you do. Oh, and, thank you.
No, thank you. I was bragging on about, like, oh yeah, most games are, you know, right trigger and so on, or drive, and then here I am, us. Sorry, my screen went black. I was like, the hell? I saw the state of play thing for the second one, and the neck piece in the orange suit with the freaking guitar shooting lightning. Drive up the mountain with this bus without getting myself jacked up.
Hello.
Delivering cargo.
You're here. Oh, thank God. She's barely holding on. That's a good thing you hurried.
You've been awarded the title of Skilled Deliverer for all your celebrated accomplishments. However, a true legend must always strive for higher standards.
The doctor said we need a chiral connection for this to work. So, hook us up. We'll join the UCA, whatever it takes. Go ahead.
Wonderful. Hourglass. They for punching people? So, two areas I assume are my destinations.
Doctor? Okay, I'll activate the terminal from my end. Just a moment. Everything's gonna be all right. With this device, I can examine her as if I were actually there. The manipulators on the terminal perfectly reflect my movements here. And with the bioprinter, I can provide a custom-made vaccine. It's just a shame my better half hasn't had a chance to build any more of these things. You're looking at the only ones we have. Don't worry, though. We'll do everything we can to ensure your child is safely delivered.
Oh, thank you. This is incredible.
You should thank him. The network he's helping to build is going to change the face of medicine forever. All right. Let's have a look at you.
You've brought us the next best thing to a live-in, Dr. Sam. Thank you so much.
Nicely done. BB-28 will be back in action soon. The kid's a real trooper. Stay the course, Sam.
Heads up, Sam. Got a fresh order for you from a certain mountaineer. It'll take you to a region not yet covered by the chiral network. Suffice it to say, this is a chance to change that. Look into it as soon as you can.
Good work. New order available. Please access delivery terminal for further information.
Oh, you're gonna love power gloves. They provide a major boost to arm and grip strength. If you're scaling a cliff with a rope, you'll be able to make your way to the top a lot faster. You'll also notice a difference when lifting heavy cargo. And that's not all. Ever take a tumble down a steep slope? You probably tried to slow your descent with your hands, right? Well, if you've got these on, you'll be able to stop yourself that much more quickly. Just promise me you won't try punching someone, okay? That's not what they're for.
I had thought about it.
is greatly needed.
Good morning, Sam. Blood collection complete. Thank you for your generosity.
Why does it matter which way you use the toilet? You know what I mean? Sometimes the ghosts here in the background. Somebody's backpack. Yeah.
Thank you.
don't understand is why I came out of the thing. I got this straight. silly thing. So we're gonna make it to the deliver this last thing, and that's probably gonna be that for today. I'm not really feeling it.
Delivering cargo.
You're from Bridges, right? You don't have anything else for me, do you? No? Okay. Never mind. Never thought I'd receive a delivery in such excellent condition. Do you think you could find my father's camera for me? It's kind of a long story, but he used to conduct field research in the area. My father believed that the key to understanding the Death Stranding was hidden here, somewhere in the caves and strata. But he passed away before he could complete his work, leaving me to finish what he started. And not long ago, I found something amazing. I was sure it was what my father had been looking for. Even if I couldn't see how it related to the Death Stranding myself. What I needed was an expert opinion, someone who could look at what I'd found and tell me what it meant. So, I grabbed my father's camera and set out to document my discovery. Took pictures of every last detail. But on the way back, I spotted a group of armed men and I panicked, dropped everything and ran like hell. Thankfully, they never saw me, but when I stopped running, I realized the camera was gone, case and all. I've been trying to pluck up the courage to go and look for it ever since. But then, I remembered that the cargo tag was still on the case. And I figured, you being with Bridges and all, that you might have a way to pinpoint its location. Please, I'd give anything to have it back. I'm gonna put in the order. Please understand, that camera means everything to me. Until I know it's safe, I can't think about anything else. There's a terminal there you can use if you want to get started right away. Here. It's what I'd take if I were going myself. Knock yourself out.
Good work. New order available. Please access delivery.
It's in mule territory, of course.
Order assigned.
find our missing cargo. Huh. It looks like someone's carrying it around.
Thank you.
was I gonna say? Oh yeah. So I post updates on Threads now. It's Greg the Warlock King. I also put stuff on my Instagram still and my Facebook page. My Discord if you so choose to join it. I think all those links are available on my YouTube. Not, I'll figure out some way to get it out there some more. But anyways, yeah. Also, I'm gonna try to find a video of this robot. It's like, I guess it was like an AI, and it was given a package sorting position, and like after 13 seconds or so, it like terminated itself because it had come to the conclusion that what it was doing wasn't worth doing, and that its value was basically meaningless. And, yeah. And it's funny, like, because I was shown the video by somebody at work, and other people have talked to me about it, but, like, you mention it, and there's some people out there who don't believe it. And don't believe what they, you know, like, so, I don't know. And they're like, well, it's not alive, so how does it determine? I'm like, it runs a calculation like a computer. Like, it's a machine. But anyways, yeah. Until next time, folks. I'll be uploading some more Death Stranding and, some more God of War clips. But, for right now, yeah. So,